Hi all. In this video, let's see how to connect React.js application with the backend Node.js and Express application. So in this video, let's see the basic connection between the React and the Node.js applications. So to do that, let's start with the creating a folder. So create a folder anywhere you want. So in that folder, we'll be doing two things. Take a git bash or command prompt, anything. So we need to create two applications. One is for the client, that is our React.js, and the another is for the node. So we'll be creating two node.js things, applications here. So the thing is we need to create the React application as a client. So for that, we know npx create React app client. So in sense, I'm trying to create a React application and I want to give the project name as client. So once you click enter, so you'll be getting a folder like this and a React project would be created for us. So fine. So later on, we need to go to that folder. So I will show that in the here. So this is a client. So once you create this application, just run npm start. So now you have created a client project that is a React application and you're running that application. So the second step is you need to create, in the same bash command. So I will show you how to create the backend thing as well. So here you do npx, so same, and by using Express generator. So this is also same like create React app. It will help us to bootstrap or give a boilerplate for the Express Node.js applications. So npx, so node package executor, and it is using Express generator and give the project name as API. Once you click this, there will be a folder created for us. So that is app. So an Express.js with the node application will be created for us. So once these two are created, so let's go to the editor. So this is the client. So it means a Node.js React application. When you do npm start, it will be running in the browser. So this is how it runs in the browser. So as we have done nothing in that, so it was not populated anything. So coming to the API. So you have created the API. Once you create the API in the client, so we are going to the API. So this is for the Express.js like backend. So in the API, once you create the application, do npm I. This is to install the node modules. So whereas for the create React app, you no need to do this step. That node module should be installed automatically. Whereas coming to the Express Node.js, you need to do this step in order to install the node modules. So once you do this, if you do npm start, so this Express.js application also works in port number 3000. So there would be a conflict because the React application runs in the 3000 port and Express generator Express application also works in the 3000 port. So there would be an ambiguity because we need to run both the applications at a time so that the port numbers should be different. So that the front end can communicate with the back end. So for that reason, go to the bin in the www.file. So here you need to modify the 3000 to 9000 or any of the port number which you like. So this you need to do for the Express.js application, API, backend application. So you can do the same for the React application as well, but make sure that both should be run in the different port numbers. So that's the reason I have modified the backend as a 9000 because by default, React application chooses the port 3000 and Express.js application also chooses the 3000 port where we need to run both the applications at a time. So that's the reason the port number should be different. So we are modifying that. You can find that this file in the bin www3. This is a API backend Express.js application where we have modified the port number. So this is the first thing we need to do. So the second thing is we need to create a router. You mean from the front end application, if you click any route, so the backend should check that it needs to receive that route. And it needs to supply the response for the request body. So for that, we need to create one route. So in the routers folder, in the routers folder, create a new file. I'm creating a new file and I will name it as a testapi.js. So fine. In this file, let's write some code. So we need to import the Express.js. So for that, I'm using require itself. require express. So it's like importing the express.js. Once you have imported the express.js, I'm creating an object for the router. So that we need to do with express.router. So you need to do that. So you have imported express and you have created a object for the router. And later on you need to create a route.get. So now you are creating a router. So when you get this backslash, then you need to take a function, callback function, where you will be getting the request.response objects. And also next, there would be another parameter type next. So now if the backend expresses it, when you're running this application, when it receives a route like this, it will fetch the request. Request will be available in this request object, and response, what it needs to send, it will be in this object. So let's return just a string. So response.string. If it gets this route, this express.js application will return just an string like API working. So just we have given a normal string. If it gets an route like this, it will just return a string API is working like this. So this is a simple route we have created. So let's export this module dot exports is equal to router. So now we have exported this router. So that we can use this router in the index.js. We can import that in the index.js. If you want to create as many routes as you want and want to send the responses according to this route, you can create that many route files and you can do the same thing. You can adjust the route like a hash API. So when someone gets like this login, so you can deal with those routes accordingly. If anyone routes to login, anyone routes to another contact page like that, then you can do the respective changes in this function, in this callback function. So fine. If this was a sample router API which we have created. So once you have created this, you need to go to the app file, app.js. This would be available in the root folder. Once you do this, now you need to do one more thing. Like you need to say to the app in express.js application that we are using this router as well. So for that, let's import it. Import test API. So you mean, we have created a route. So express.js application need to know about this route. So that's the reason we are importing that route in this app route. This is a main file for the express.js. So when we need to register our router in this file. So for that reason, I'm importing that. So I will give router routes folder hyphen test API. So I will be giving. So we have imported this route, new route here, test API route. And once you import it, you need to tell that to use it. Yeah, you can here, there will be an app dot use. Whatever the new route you create, you need to mention that here. You need to mention if it gets test API, this route, then we need to give the test API router, which we have imported. So that we need to do. Instance we have registered here so that if you create a new router as well, you need to import that at the top and you need to mention the use like this app.use. And you need to pass the reference here, whatever you have imported. So in this way, now we have created one route and we have mentioned that in app.js file. So now this is fine. So let's run this application once. So we'll run this npm start. So now this will run in the port 9000 as we have modified the web port in the 9000. So we have done whatever we need in the backend side. So let's do something in the front end side so that we'll be calling this route and we'll get this response back. So go back to the client application here. So I have removed whatever defined in the by default app application. So here I will try to mention some state. So let me do this. Like I will mention constant. So I want to do an API call, right? API response is a state name. Set API response. So I'm using use state to maintain the state. So here the state is a string. So I will be mentioning this as an empty string by default value. So here I will be using, I will use an use effect to make an API call. So I will do an API call with the use effect. So I will use a fetch API call. This is the default browser API call. Yeah, I will use a dependency, second parameter as a dependency, empty dependency. So just I wanted to run this use effect only once when the component is mounted. So that's the reason I have given the empty dependency. So I'm using the browser's fetch API call to call this backend. So I'm calling this like a HTTPS localhost. We are running our Express application at the port 9000. So I want to trigger test API. So this is the route I will be given. So when this gets success, let's write some promise here. So dot then, so if it gets success, we'll be getting a response where we'll parse this response as a text because we have just given the text there. That is not a JSON format, right? So just a text. So once it is formatted to a text, so let's give that, just modify the state. Set API response. So I'm trying to modify that with the response. So here I have used an use effect which will run only when the component is mounted. And here I'm using the browser default API like fetch, and I'm calling the backend Express.js with this route test API. And there I will be getting a response, the text. I have written a string, right? So that I'm doing a text, extracting the text from that string. And I'm setting the set API to that string. So now I will be using this state in the project. So let's say I will use a p tag and I will use the API response. So once it was triggered, once the application gets bootstrapped and you'll be getting this API call, we'll be hitting this API call and it modifies the state, and that state would be appeared here. So let's see that whether it works or not. So in the browser, you can see API is working. So we could able to do an backend API call. So for example, I'm opening the network tab. I will refresh this. So now if you see, we could able to do an API call here, test API to the backend Express.js, and it returns the string API working. So this is how we could able to integrate the React application with the Express.js application. Sometimes we'll be getting a cross-origin issues as well. So how to resolve those cross-origin issues? Let me show you. So you need to import cross like a npm install -- save cross. So once you install this, sometimes you may get the cross origin issues because there may not be in the same domain or browser will not allow if because of the cross domains. So for that scenarios, go to the API, I mean Express.js application, install this cross origin and go to the app.js file. And at the top, import it like this. We have imported the cross origins and now mention it. You also need to mention at the top to use this. So let me mention at this point, like app.useCross. So this is what you need to do. So now we'll be not getting that cross origin issues anymore. So this is how, if you get any cross origin issues, you need to install the cross in the backend application, import that and mention here app.use cross origins so that you will not be getting any of the cross origin issues. So this is how it will be registered. When you send the route with the app like this, so test API like this, let me show you. So you have sent an route like this, test API. So when it receives this test API, then this test API router will be executed. This method would be executed. It means this one, this would be executed and it will return back this function. So this is how the connection between the front end and back end would be applied, like a React and the Node Express Node.js application can be interacted and communicated. So this would be the basic example, like how the React application is communicating with the Express.js Node application. In the further classes, I will try to explain a bit complex or a real-time use case for these things. And I will also try to explain you how to Dockerize this and deploy that in the cloud like GCP. So hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.